तो हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन दिस क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट टॉपिक दैट इज इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ एनएमआर सिग्नल्स फॉर सर्टेन फंक्शनल ग्रुप्स व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट इन दी ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स। सो एक्चुअली एनएमआर स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टेक्निक फॉर द डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स, बिकॉज एक्चुअली ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स कंटेन्स मेनली कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन एटम्स, एंड इन सम केसेस इट ऑल्सो कंटेन नाइट्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन, बट मैक्सिमम द पोर्शन ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड इज द कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन मीन्स, एंड ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स आर दी यू नो दी ओरिजिनेटेड फ्रॉम दी हाइड्रोकार्बन्स एक्चुअली, एंड हाइड्रोकार्बन्स कंटेन्स मेनली कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन। एंड एनएमआर स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी कैन बी यूज्ड टू डिटरमाइन दी ऑक्सीजन सॉरी दी कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन एटम्स। बाय यूजिंग कार्बन 13 एनएमआर वी कैन डिटरमाइन दी हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ दी एंड हाउ मेनी नंबर ऑफ दी कार्बन प्रेजेंट इन दी कंपाउंड। एंड बाय प्रोटॉन एनएमआर स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी दैट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज 1H एनएमआर इन शॉर्ट, एंड दिस कैन बी यूज फॉर दी इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ सिग्नल विच आर ऑब्टेंड बाई दी एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ रेडियो रेडिएशन बाई प्रोटोन्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन दी ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड। सो हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ द प्रोटोन्स आर प्रेजेंट इन दी कंपाउंड एंड हाउ मेनी नंबर्स ऑफ द प्रोटोन्स आर प्रेजेंट and how many types of the protons are present in the compound can easily be determined by using proton NMR spectroscopic technique. Okay, so if we can determine the types of the proton and number of the protons present in the organic compound, then we can easily determine the number you know the types of the groups means type of the functional groups present in the compound, right? So now the learning objective of this class to learn the concept of chemical safety value for from functional groups. So actually the parameter which is used for the determination of the functional group is the chemical safety value that is shown in delta value, right? And also we can show this by tau value, right? So if we can know if we know the chemical value for the protons, then we can easily identify that this proton is of which functional group, right? And the understanding of to interpret the NMR signal. So once we get the information of the protons of the particular functional group, then we can easily interpret the NMR signals, right? And the learning outcomes of this class is student can interpret the NMR signals of various functional group and they can determine the various functional group which are present in the organic molecule, right? And the second one is these students will be able to determine the structure of organic compounds. So if we have the knowledge about the functional group present in the compound, then almost we can determine the structure of organic compounds, right? Just one minute. Now, in the continuation of interpretation of NMR signal with respect to the various functional groups, this is the first or the simplest group present in the organic compound, that is alkanes, right? Simplest organic compounds are the alkanes, and alkanes have three types of hydrogens like methyl hydrogens, methylene hydrogens, and methane hydrogens, right? So what do you mean by the methylene and methane hydrogen actually? So if this group is present in the compound, then it is called as methyl group, right? And if this group is present, CH2 group is present, the compound, then it is called as methylene group. While if this group is present in the compound here where one hydrogen is present with the carbon or attached with the carbon, then in that case that is called as methyl group, right? Methyl group. So for each type of group, the chemical separation value is different, right? And on the basis of this chemical separation value, we can determine the functional group or the groups which contain the protons, right? For example, if we have this methyl group and this is connected with R group is not specified here, okay? So what is this actually? This may be methyl, ethyl, propyl, isopropyl. This may be other type of the group, but we are talking about the protons present in this CH3 group, right? Methyl group, okay? So for these methyl groups, the chemical separation value is around 0.7 to 1.3 ppm. It means these values are very closer to the value of TMS, delta value of the TMS. And the delta value of the TMS is zero. Why this is zero? Because for the protons of the TMS, TMS protons are very highly shielded. These are highly shielded protons. And for highly shielded protons, the delta value, we consider the delta value zero, right? To make a parameter of delta values, okay? And the other organic compound does not show actually the most of the compound. Most of the organic compound does not show, do not show the absorbance at zero delta value, okay? Means TMS delta value does not create interference with the signal of the other organic compound. So for methyl proton, the delta value is 0.7 to 1.3. It means the electron density around these protons, CH3 protons, is almost equal to that of the electron density present in the TMS. Okay, and in the previous classes, I also discussed this thing that as increase the electron density around the protons, electron density is if increased, then it shield the protons. Means shielding of the proton is increased. If shielding of the proton increased, then we have to apply more and more external magnetic field to get the NMR signal of that particular proton. Okay, and this proton, if electron density is high around this proton, then this proton is called shielded proton. And for shielded proton, our signal, we observe the signal of that shielded proton at high field. Okay, because high field is required to generate the signal of that proton. Why? क्योंकि देखो यहाँ प्रोटॉन के अराउंड इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी ज्यादा होगी, तो इस ये जो अप्लाइड फील्ड हम लगाएंगे, ये अप्लाइड फील्ड को ये इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी इस प्रोटॉन तक नहीं पहुंचने देगी, तो हमें हाई फील्ड अप्लाई करना पड़ेगा, राइट? वी हैव टू इंक्रीज द फील्ड, ओके, टू गेट द एनएमआर सिग्नल ऑफ दैट प्रोटॉन, राइट? सो नाउ द केमिकल सो द इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी अराउंड दीज प्रोटॉन्स इज वेरी हाई, सो इट्स सिग्नल्स अपीयर very closer to the signal of TMS, okay? And in the case of methylene proton, the chemical shift value is in the range of 1.2 to 1.4 ppm, right? So if this value is for methylene proton, and this value is greater than the value which is obtained for methyl proton, right? It means the electron density around this proton is less than the electron density around this methyl group, right? And when if you talk about the chemical shift value of methyl proton, then in that case the delta value is 1.4 to 1.7 ppm. It means the electron density around this proton is decreased with respect to these protons, right? So as decrease the electron density around this proton, it decreases, sorry, it you know, the it dispels the proton, and our signal will observe in the downfield region or at the lower field. Okay, so this actually the applied magnetic field means a field shift means delta value is lower, and downfield shift means delta value is higher. Means delta value, scale of the delta value is just opposite. Suppose scale of delta value is this in increasing order, then our applied field is in this order. Means they are opposite. Their scale is opposite in NMR, not the spectrum, right? So suppose we have a unknown compound, right? And for this unknown compound, our signal is appeared at around 1.3 ppm or at 1.4 ppm, 1.4 ppm. Then in that case, we can easily identify this thing that this peak will be observed for methylene proton either or for methane proton. Okay, so now there is some confusion that this value 1.4 ppm value is for also methane, and this is also for methylene proton. So how we can clarify this thing that the protons are of either methylene group and or of methane group? So how we can clarify this thing? So we can clarify this thing on the basis of the peak area. Peak area present in the signal. Okay, so as increase the number of proton in the group, the peak area is also increased in the also increased, right? So on the basis of the peak area ratio of the signals, we can identify that the number of protons which are present in the particular group are what, right? Because if the signal is appeared for CH proton, then the peak area ratio will be just half to that of CH2 proton, right? And all and other factor, other parameters also the splitting the signal. So how many members of the protons are present at the neighborhood position will split the signal of the particular proton, right? So if this group, if CH2 group is present at the neighborhood position of the particular proton, then this CH2 group split the signal of that particular proton into triplet. So if the suppose this R group is this R group CH3 group, right? Then the signal of CH3 group will split into the three peaks due to the interaction of three spin orientation of these CH2 protons, right? So there are various parameters, you know, by which we can easily interpret that the group is either CH2 or CH group, right? So we can determine CH2 group which is present in the compound by using, this is the example spectra of this compound. This is CH3 CH2 whole 6CH3. This is octane compound. Octane means 8 carbon containing compound. Okay, there are 8 carbons and two groups are methyl group here, CH3 CH3 groups, right, at the terminal position, and in the mid there are 6 CH2 groups. Okay, so if we consider these CH3 groups proton like A type of proton and CH2 proton for like B type of proton, then we can see in the NMR spectra here that two peaks will be observed for this compound, because in this compound there are two types of the protons which are present in the chemical environment. Means this CH3 and CH3 groups are present in the same chemical environment, because the groups attached with this CH3 group is CH2, and the group attached with this CH3 group is also CH2. So both these CH3 groups are attached with the same CH2 group, same type of the group. That's why the CH3 CH3 protons, both the CH3 CH3 protons are equivalent proton. And for equivalent protons in NMR spectroscopy, we observe only one signal, right? And for B type of proton, all the six CH2 groups, all the six CH2 groups present in this chain are also equivalent, right? So if these are equivalent, then we observed only one signal in the NMR spectra for CH2 protons or B type of the proton. So the signal for B type of proton is this. This is the signal, and this is the signal. This is the signal for A type of proton. Okay. So we can easily here see that the peak area or the peak height for B type of proton is very high, means higher than the peak area or peak height of A type of proton. Why this is so? Because B type of protons are 12 in number. They are 12 protons, while A type of protons are 6. So B type of protons are just double in number than that of the number of A type of proton. That's the reason why the peak area of this signal, this area of the signal for B is just double to that of the area of the signal A, right? So actually the area and height, overall the area of the signal is depends, or this is directly proportional to the number of protons for each type, right? And the peak is just closer to zero value, means this is towards zero value. It means it is appeared at a field region than compared to this B signal, because B types of protons are they are less shielded than the A type of the proton. Okay, electron density around the A type of proton is greater than the electron density around CH2 type of the proton, right? Now if you talk about the another category of the compound, and that is alkene, right? So for alkene, actually two types of the hydrogens are present. First is vinyl type of the hydrogen. Vinyl means why? In the vinyl type of hydrogen, the hydrogen is present with the doubly bonded carbon. This is the doubly bonded carbon, this is also the doubly bonded carbon. Okay, so these are present with the doubly bonded carbon. And second type of the protons are allylic protons, allylic hydrogen. So allylic hydrogens are present. This is the allylic hydrogen. This is present at the alpha carbon with respect to this doubly bonded carbon, okay, or the double bond. With respect to this double bond, this carbon is alpha carbon, or that is also called allylic carbon. And the hydrogen present on this allylic carbon is called allylic proton, okay? So for if we talk about the chemical safety value for vinylic carbon, then it is 4.5 to 6.5 ppm. This is very high. Either this proton is present on the this carbon atom, and carbon atom is not too much of electronegative, but still the chemical safety value for this vinylic proton is 4.5 to 6.5 ppm. This is very high. Why this is so high? Why this proton is too much deshielded proton? Because according to the anisotropic effect, actually anisotropic effect work in the unsaturated compound, especially for alkenes type of compound where double bonds is present in a compound. So if double bonds is present in a compound, alkene type of compound, then these protons which are present in the alkene type of compound or the doubly bonded carbon of the alkene compound, it may be a aromatic compound and it may be aliphatic compound, but it should be alkene, right? So for alkene type of compound, the hydrogens are present in the paramagnetic zone, or we can say in the deshielding zone. where it means the induced magnetic field. The induced magnetic field generated by the circulation of this pi electron density, this double bond, creates two type of magnetic field. One is deshielding or two type of magnetic field. One is paramagnetic zone and second is diamagnetic zone. Or we can say one field that is shielding zone and second is deshielding zone. So in case of alkene or aromatic compound, the hydrogen present in deshielding zone means this field created by circulation of these pi electrons deshield these protons. If this deshield this proton, then its signal will appear at highly downfield region, because in case of deshielding, our signal will we will observe the our signal at lower applied magnetic field. Okay, or as increase the electron density, or if hydrogen is present in the shielding zone, then we have to put or we have to increase the applied magnetic field to get the NMR signal of that particular proton, right? Now the second category of alkene is the allylic proton. The for allylic protons, the signal appeared at around 1.6 to 2.6 ppm. So there is no much, you know, the downfield shifting, or there is, we can say that there is a field shift of the this proton with respect to this proton. Why this is so? Because this proton is attached with the carbon. This carbon and that carbon is singly bonded. Singly bonded means it has only sigma bonds, right? And the hybridization of this carbon is sp3 hybridization. So as in case of sp3 hybridization, the proton is you know, highly shielded. The proton is highly shielded because there is no working of the anisotropic effect. There is no anisotropic effect, no creation of the deshielding zone, then there is no deshielding of this proton, and there is no downfield shift. Okay, like that. Okay, so for this compound, for this proton, the NMR signal appear around 1.6 to 2.6 ppm. In this range means, right? And the coupling behavior, coupling constant for alkene type of the protons is like this. This is the coupling behavior, means spin-spin coupling between two protons which are present here. In this compound, the these two protons, one first and second, these protons are present at three bond distance. This is one, this is second, this is third. There is three bonds between these two protons. Okay, so the coupling is the interaction of the electronic field. Interaction of the electronic field means the shifting and movement of the electrons between these two protons. Okay, if the shifting or transfer of the or the movement of the electron density in between these two protons is high, it means these protons couple, means spin of these protons couple at strongly, right? If their spin orientation couple strongly, or they you know, the then in that case the coupling constant will be high, right? If there is no too much coupling or poor coupling is between protons, right, then in that case there is poor coupling constant for the compound. So for this compound J is the coupling constant. Trans means these two protons are present at transposition, means one proton is either present if this proton is present below the plane of this double bond plane of this double bond, then this proton is present above the plane. Okay, so means one proton is above the plane and second proton position is below the plane. So in that case these protons are called as transproton. Okay, so there is, since coupling between these transprotons, so this is called J trans, means trans coupling constant for transproton. And this is third, J3. J3 3 means there is 3 bond distance between 2 protons, right? And the value for J3 trans is 11 to 18 hertz. That is very high coupling between trans protons. So actually the coupling or the the transformation of the electron density between two protons depends upon the bond angle between angle between these protons. So actually the angle between these protons is 180 degrees. This is that is highest between two bonds, right? So if this is highest, then in that case there is very high coupling between two protons and coupling constant will be very high, right? But if we talk about the coupling between this carbon hydrogen and this hydrogen, then in that case there is very poor coupling because there is the bond angle between these protons is very low. This is zero, right? So in that case there is no transformation or the shifting of the electron density between these protons. So that's why its coupling constant is very low. Okay, so for coupling of the or the for interaction of the electrons, there is requirement of the planarity in the compound. So if the compound is planar and two protons are present in this plane, two protons are present at 180 degree angle, then in that case there will be coupling. Okay, if you talk about the coupling constant between two protons, these two protons are actually for the bonds between these two protons are 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. The four bond distance is there between two protons, right? So that's why the coupling between two protons is called 4J. I mean J4, and the value is 0 to 3 hertz. So actually, if two protons are present at double bonded carbon, वो भी डिफरेंट कार्बन, सेम कार्बन या डिफरेंट कार्बन, तो कपलिंग कॉन्स्टेंट की वैल्यू बहुत ज्यादा होती है, ठीक है? बट इफ देर आर फोर और मोर देन फोर बॉन्ड डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू कार्बन, टू प्रोटॉन, सॉरी, देर आर फोर और मोर देन फोर बॉन्ड डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू प्रोटॉन्स, राइट? एंड देर इज नो अल्टरनेट, देर इज नो सिंगल एंड डबल बॉन्ड्स एट अल्टरनेट पोजिशन, राइट? इन दैट केस देर इज नो प्लेनिटी इन दिस मॉलिक्यूल, राइट? मीन्स दिस हाइड्रोजन इज प्रेजेंट एट sp3 हाइब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन, सो देर इज नो प्लेनिटी, दिस सेंटर इज टेट्राहेड्रल सेंटर, राइट? एंड दिस कार्बन हैज द प्लेनिटी, देर इज डबल बॉन्ड, सो दिस हैज द प्लेनिटी बिकॉज sp2 हाइब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन हैज द 3 sigma bonds at the same plane, right? But this is in the plane, but this proton is not in the plane. Okay, so there is a disturbance of the planarity, and if disturbance of the planarity is there, then in that case there is not the spin-spin coupling between two protons. Very poor, very very poor. That's why the value for coupling constant of these two protons is in between 0 to 3 hertz, right? Now this is the compound. We can take this compound. We are taking here this compound for to explain the chemical shift value, and we can interpret the structure of this compound on the basis of NMR signal. So in this spectra, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five peaks. There are five peaks. Okay. So 5 peaks means in this compound, 5 type of the protons are present. One type of this CH3, second is CH2, third is this CH3, fourth is this CH2 proton, and fifth is CH2 proton. अब आप कहोगे कि भाई ये CH2 है, CH2 CH2 है, सारे ग्रुप तो एक ही जैसा है, वो एक ही जैसे तो प्रोटॉन भी एक ही जैसे हो, बट ऐसा नहीं है, ठीक है? इनके लिए जो जो डेल्टा वैल्यू होगी वो अलग अलग, क्यों? क्योंकि इनके केमिकल एनवायरमेंट अलग है. कैसा है? दिस सी एच टू ग्रुप इज प्रेजेंट, दिस इज प्रेजेंट विद दिस इज कनेक्टेड विद दिस कार्बन बाय डबल बॉन्ड्स. तो डबल बॉन्ड कैरेक्टर आते हैं, यहाँ पे केमिकल एनवायरनमेंट चेंज हो जाएगा, इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी चेंज हो जाएगी, बॉन्ड लेंथ, बॉन्ड स्ट्रेंथ वो चेंज हो जाएगी, ठीक है? इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी अराउंड द प्रोटॉन भी चेंज हो जाएगी, बिकॉज एस पी दिस कार्बन दिस कार्बन डबली बॉन्डेड कार्बन्स आर एस पी टू हाइब्रिडाइज्ड, एंड इफ दिस आर एस पी टू हाइब्रिडाइज्ड देन दिस कार्बन्स हैव द हाई इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव हाई इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी, दे अट्रैक्ट द शेयर्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी फ्रॉम द हाइड्रोजन एंड डिसील्ड दिस हाइड्रोजन. ओके एंड सेकेंड थिंग इज एनिसोट्रॉपिक इफेक्ट इज ऑल्सो देयर इन एल्किन कंपाउंड. So both the factors, inductive effect, minus A effect, and the anisotropic effect, both the effect deseal these protons. That is the reason that for these protons, this signal appeared at high, you know, very high downfield region. This is the very high downfield region. Okay, and for these compounds, this CH3 group and this CH3 group, these are also different because this CH3 group is attached with the doubly bonded carbon, while this CH3 group is attached with the CH2 group. So the chemical environment around these groups are different. So different, then these protons are considered non-equivalent proton. And for non-equivalent proton, different peaks are appeared, right? So for A type of proton, this peak is appeared. Because A type of protons are very shielded proton. Why this is shielded? Because this is connected with these alkyl groups, and these alkyl groups shows plus A effect, means electron releasing effect. They increase the electron density around CH3 proton, right? So these CH3 protons are highly shielded, and signal appeared at a field region, means towards zero ppm value, right? And for B type of protons are also shielded proton. Note, three shielded नहीं जितने CH3 proton shielded है, right? But shielded है, ठीक है? Shielded because there is CH3 group. This shows plus effect on this proton and increase the electron density. This also increase, but not too much. Actually, there is sp2 hybridized carbon. So sp2 hybridized carbon attracted the electron density of this bond, and this also attracted this bond. That's why the electron density around this CH2 protons somewhat decreased with respect to the electron density around this CH3 proton. Okay, तो इसीलिए इसके जो सिग्नल मिलेंगे वो ऐसे हैं, एक जो सिग्नल है उससे कम, इससे थोड़ा सा डाउनफील्ड रीजन में मिलेगा, क्योंकि बी पर इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी ए के कंपेरिजन में थोड़ी कम है, राइट? एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द CH3, द CH3 प्रोटॉन्स आर CH3 ग्रुप इज होल्ड इज अटैच्ड विद द sp2 हाइब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन. यहाँ पर sp2 हाइब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन का क्या भी होगा, यहाँ पर माइनस आई इफेक्ट होगा. माइनस आई इफेक्ट होगा तो ये और डिसील्ड रीजन में मिलेंगे, आई मीन डाउनफील्ड रीजन में सिग्नल मिलेगा. तो इसका सिग्नल डाउनफील्ड रीजन में मिल रहा है बी के रिस्पेक्ट में, और भी डाउनफील्ड है, ठीक है? और जो डी का है वो और भी ज्यादा डाउनफील्ड में मिलेगा. क्यों मिलेगा? क्योंकि डी के सी एच टू ग्रुप जो है उससे कार्बन के साथ है, ठीक है? तो इस कार्बन, ये जो कार्बन है ये माइनस आई इफेक्ट शो करता है, और दैट्स द रीजन व्हाई इट्स सिग्नल शिफ्टेड टुवर्ड्स डाउनफील्ड रीजन. And E protons are very disordered because of anisotropic effect, right? So these are the five signals for this compound. Now, if you talk about the splitting, the you know the एक पैरामीटर तो हो गया कि केमिकल सेट की वैल्यू के बेसिस पर हमने एक्सप्लेन कर लिया कि भाई ये इस प्रोटोन के लिए यहाँ पर सिग्नल मिलेगा, इसके लिए यहाँ पर सिग्नल मिलेगा. लेकिन मान लो आपको कहीं कोई कंफ्यूजन है कि भाई सी एस टू के लिए या सी एस थ्री के लिए, तो हो सकता है सी एस टू के लिए और भी ज्यादा आप फील्ड में मिलना चाहिए. तो फिर हम इनकी जो पीक्स हैं, इनकी पीक्स एरिया को देखेंगे. तो जिस टाइप के प्रोटोन जितने नंबर में होंगे, जितने ज्यादा क्वांटिटी में होंगे, उस प्रोटोन का जो सिग्नल होगा उसकी पीक एरिया उतना ही ज्यादा होगा. तो देखिए, ये जो ए टाइप ऑफ प्रोटोन, फोर ए टाइप ऑफ प्रोटोन, द सिग्नल द एरिया ऑफ द सिग्नल इज दिस वेरी हाई. फोर सी टाइप ऑफ प्रोटोन एरिया ऑफ सिग्नल इज वेरी हाई बिकॉज फोर सी एस थ्री प्रोटोन्स आर थ्री प्रोटोन्स, राइट? एंड सी एस टू प्रोटोन्स आर टू प्रोटोन्स. सो जो भी पीक एरिया सी एस टू प्रोटोन का आएगा उसकी रेस्पेक्ट में सी एस थ्री प्रोटोन का पीक एरिया हाई होगा, राइट? इसलिए सी एंड ए जो टाइप के प्रोटोन है, सी एस थ्री प्रोटोन, फॉर दिस प्रोटोन्स द पीक एरिया इज हाई, राइट? देन द पीक एरिया ऑफ द सी एस टू प्रोटोन्स बी बी एंड ई, राइट? एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो आइडेंटिफाई दीज पीक्स फॉर द बेसिस ऑफ द स्प्लिटिंग ऑफ द सिग्नल. as this signal, a type of proton, this signal is splitted into triplet. Three peaks are there in this signal. And CH2 protons are splitted into the देखो ये जो CH2 प्रोटॉन के लिए पीक काफी ज्यादा ब्रॉड है, ब्रॉड ही नहीं है एक्चुअली, यहाँ पर बहुत सारी छोटी छोटी पीक्स है। ये जो सिग्नल है इसका ये काफी ज्यादा पीक्स के अंदर, कितने पीक में स्प्लिट होता है, दिस इज स्प्लिटेड इनटू अराउंड द सिक्स पीक। 3 + 2 मींस 5, 5 + एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू n+1 रूल दीस आर अपीयर्ड एट द सिग्नल फॉर CH2 प्रोटॉन इज स्प्लिटेड इनटू सिक्स पीक्स। तो देयर आर सिक्स पीक्स इन दिस कंपाउंड, two are these and two are these, okay? So this is sextet, okay? You will also later that this signal is splitted into six peaks. This is a triplet. And for C proton, there is no splitting of the signal. That's why this C proton, C signal, signal for C proton is just a single line. It's a single line. There is no splitting of the signal into various peaks because there is nor the presence of hydrogen atom at this adjacent carbon. If at adjacent carbon there is no presence of hydrogen, then there is no splitting of the signal for the particular protons, right? That's the reason why singlet is appeared for C type of proton, right? And before d type of proton, at the adjacent position, two protons are present, right? So if two protons are present at the adjacent position of d type of proton, then signal for d type of proton is split into triplet according to n+1 rule, where n is the number of proton adjacent position. So this is triplet, okay? And this is appeared as just like singlet. Now the next category of the compound is alkynes. So alkynes have two types of the hydrogen, styrene hydrogen and alpha hydrogen found on carbon atom next to the triple bond. So this is the acetylenic proton. For acetylenic proton, the chemical shift value is 1.72 2.7 ppm. Why this is so? Because acetylene proton anisotropic effect is also working. And due to the anisotropic effect, these protons are singlet proton actually. Because in case of alkynes, the protons are present in the shielding zone. And in the shielding zone, we have to put the higher magnetic field to get the NMR spectrum. Means our signal appeared at higher magnetic field. Okay. And for alpha protons with respect to these alkynes, this value is 1.6 to 2.6. So for both the type of proton, both the protons, alpha or acetylenic protons, the delta value is almost at equal value, right? There is no effect of the effect of anisotropic effect in both the cases. And the coupling coefficient between two protons, this and this proton, these are actually have four bond distance. And if there is four bond distance, then the coupling constant value will be very low, around 2 to 3. Because in case of four or more than four bond distance hydrogen, the coupling is very low. Just like inductive effect. कि जैसे जैसे बॉन्ड की डिस्टेंस इंक्रीज होती जाती है, आई मीन द नंबर ऑफ बॉन्ड्स बिटवीन टू सेंटर इंक्रीज होते जाता है, वैसे वैसे जो फील्ड ट्रांसफर होता है, फील्ड ट्रांसफर की इंटेंसिटी कम होती जाती है। तो सेम थिंग इज हियर। देर इज ऑल्सो द फील्ड ट्रांसफर इंटेंसिटी ऑफ द फील्ड ट्रांसफर इज वेरी और द डिक्रीजिंग एज इंक्रीज द नंबर ऑफ बॉन्ड। तो एक फैक्टर तो ये है, दूसरा सेकेंड फैक्टर इज दैट कि यहाँ पर जो ये प्रोटोन है, दिस प्रोटोन इज प्रेजेंट एट sp3 हाइब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन, एंड sp3 हाइब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन इज नॉन प्लैनर सेंटर। सो इफ दिस इज नॉन प्लैनर सेंटर, देन द कपलिंग और द शिफ्टिंग ऑफ द फील्ड बिटवीन टू प्रोटॉन्स इज वेरी 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 लो। दैट्स द रीजन व्हाई कपलिंग कांस्टेंट वैल्यू इज वेरी लो फॉर दिस प्रोटॉन्स। एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द वन पेंटाइन कंपाउंड, इट इज द कैटेगरी ऑफ एल्काइन टाइप ऑफ द कंपाउंड। सो फॉर पेंटाइन कंपाउंड देर आर फोर टाइप ऑफ द प्रोटॉन्स, ए बी सी एंड A, B, C, and D. Actually, why we have marked these compound as A, B, C, and D? So this is on the basis of their chemical shift value. So for a proton, the chemical shift value is very low. Means this is its signal appeared at very high field. Then B is at lower field than that of the A signal, and for C, this is downfield with respect to the B signal, and for D type of proton, the signal is at very low field. Okay, so for A type, B type, C type, and D type of protons, there are four type of the signal. So four signals, appearance of the four signal in the NMR spectra shows that in the pentane molecule there are four types of the proton. Okay, and the splitting of the signal into various peaks shows that which group is present in the neighborhood position of the particular proton. For example, C type की प्रोटॉन है, C type की प्रोटॉन की नेबरहुड वाला है कार्बन पर कोई प्रोटॉन नहीं है, तो C type की प्रोटॉन का जो सिग्नल होगा वो सिंगलेट की फॉर्म में मिलेगा. देयर इज नो स्प्लिटिंग ऑफ द C type ऑफ द सिग्नल, दिस ओनली वन ही पीक मिलेगी सिग्नल में. ठीक है, दैट इज कॉल्ड सिंगलेट. एंड जो B type के प्रोटॉन है इसके अराउंड 5 प्रोटॉन है, तो 5 प्रोटॉन है, तो अकॉर्डिंग टू n+1 देयर आर 6 पीक्स इन द सिग्नल. ओके, and for D type proton there are three peaks in the signal, means triplet is there. Now alkali lead have one type of the hydrogen, that is alpha hydrogen. This is the alpha hydrogen, the one attached to this same carbon at the as the halogen. So actually this carbon, which is directly attached with this halogen atom is the alpha carbon, and hydrogen is the alpha hydrogen. Okay, so as we move from up to down, then the electronegativity of these halogen atoms increasing in order, right? There are increasing order of the electronegativity, means the power to attract the shared electron density between carbon and halogen is in increasing order if we move from iodine to bromine, bromine to chlorine, and chlorine to fluorine. So fluorine is the most electronegative atom, not in the halogen family, but also in the whole periodic tables, right? So for fluorine, the electronegativity is very high. So means it attract the said electron density strongly, means it decreases the electron density around the proton, means deseal the proton. If deseal the proton, then its signal appear at low magnetic field. Low magnetic field means higher delta value, 4.2 to 4.8, right? While this is lowest, it has lowest electronegativity, so it does not attract the electron density or the shared electron density effectively. Okay, very less, up to very less extent it attracts the electron density. It does not decrease the electron density around this proton very much. Okay, तो बहुत ही कम इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी जब डिक्रीज करता है, तो इसके लिए डेल्टा वैल्यू भी क्या आती है, कम आती है, बिकॉज दीज आर दिस इज शील्डेड प्रोटॉन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दिस प्रोटॉन, राइट? इफ दिस इज शील्डेड देन इट्स सिग्नल विल अपीयर एट हाई फील्ड, मींस लोअर डेल्टा वैल्यू 0.02 4.0 ppm. सो एज इंक्रीज एफ वी एज वी मूव फ्रॉम अप टू डाउन द इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी ऑफ दिस हैलोजन इंक्रीजिंग एंड द प्रोटॉन्स आर descending. If protons are descending, then their delta value will appear at downfield shift. If their signal appeared at downfield shift, our delta value will be in increasing order. So this is the 1-chlorobutane, and for 1-chlorobutane there are four types of the protons. So four signals are there: A, B, C, and D. This depends upon the electronegative electron density around these protons, or the minus effect of this proton. So actually जिस सेंटर के साथ हेलोजन एटम प्रेजेंट होता है उस सेंटर पर माइनस इफेक्ट सबसे ज्यादा लगता है, एंड जैसे जैसे हेलोजन एटम्स हैं इन कार्बन की डिस्टेंस बढ़ती जाती है, तो जैसे जैसे दूर वाले दूर होते जाते हैं डिस्टेंस इंक्रीज होती जाती है. जैसे फर्स्ट कार्बन है, इसकी डिस्टेंस कम है, तो इस पर सबसे ज्यादा माइनस इफेक्ट लगेगा, मीन्स इस पर इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी सबसे कम हो जाएगी, फिर उसके बाद इस पर, फिर उसके बाद इस पर, और इस मिथाइल पर तो इसका माइनस इफेक्ट लगेगा ही नहीं, तो नहीं लगेगा, तो फिर इसकी जो सिग्नल है ना वो हाई फील्ड में मिलेगी, ठीक है, और इसके सिग्नल सबसे ज्यादा लोअर फील्ड में मिलेंगे। तो देखो यहाँ पर फॉर डी टाइप ऑफ प्रोटोन दिस सिग्नल इज अपेयर्ड एट वेरी लो फील्ड, एंड फॉर ए टाइप ऑफ प्रोटोन द सिग्नल इज अपेयर्ड एट हायर अप फील्ड, राइट, दैट इज द रीजन, एंड स्प्लिटिंग इज ऑल्सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द एन प्लस वन रूल। ओके, सो नाउ द अनदर कैटेगरी इज द एल्कोहल। एल्कोहल हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ द हाइड्रोजन, ओके, सो वी विल डिस्कस दिस कैटेगरी इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास। दीज आर एमसीक्यूज बेस्ड ऑन दिस क्लास। एरोमेटिक कंपाउंड्स हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ द हाइड्रोजन। विच टाइप ऑफ द हाइड्रोजन दे हैव? दे हैव द बेंजाइलिक हाइड्रोजन एंड बेंजील हाइड्रोजन, दिस इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन सी। एंड द केमिकल शिफ्ट वैल्यू फॉर C6H5H इज, तो दिस इज एक्चुअली द एरोमेटिक प्रोटॉन, सो फॉर दिस द केमिकल शिफ्ट वैल्यू इज इन द रेंज ऑफ 6.5 टू 8, एंड फॉर सी टाइप ऑफ केमिकल शिफ्ट वैल्यू फॉर एल 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 आई सी दिस एलाइलिक, नॉट द एलाइलिक, दिस प्रोटॉन दिस इज अराउंड 0.7 टू 1.3 ppm, एंड द केमिकल शिफ्ट वैल्यू फॉर दिस वाइनिलिक प्रोटॉन, सो फॉर वाइनिलिक प्रोटॉन केमिकल शिफ्ट वैल्यू इज इन दिस रेंज फॉर 4.5 टू 6.5, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन दी पीपीटीज, एंड द केमिकल शिफ्ट वैल्यू फॉर RCH3 ग्रुप इज दिस इज 0.7 टू 1.3, फॉर मिथाइल प्रोटॉन इट इज द केमिकल शिफ्ट वैल्यू इज बिटवीन 7.0.7 टू 1.3, एंड द केमिकल शिफ्ट वैल्यू फॉर ROCH2 दिस मिथाइलिन प्रोटॉन इज 1.2 टू 1.4, एंड द केमिकल शिफ्ट वैल्यू फॉर दिस एल्कोहलिक प्रोटॉन, एल्कोहलिक प्रोटॉन इज अराउंड, यू नो दिस इज अराउंड 3.2 टू 3.8, एंड वी विल डिस्कस दिस एमसीक्यूज। यस, फॉर दिस व्हाट विल बी द करेक्ट मल्टीप्लिसिटी ऑफ द सिग्नल ऑफ द बी टाइप ऑफ द प्रोटॉन, सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दैट मल्टीप्लिसिटी ऑफ द सिग्नल मींस इन हाउ मच पीक्स अ सिग्नल स्प्लिट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द नंबर ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट इन द नेबरहुड पोजीशन, एंड अकॉर्डिंगली अकॉर्डिंग टू द एन प्लस वन रूल द सिग्नल इज स्प्लिटेड इनटू द वेरियस पीक। ओके, व्हाट विल बी द करेक्ट मल्टीप्लिसिटी ऑफ द सिग्नल ऑफ द डी टाइप ऑफ प्रोटॉन इन दिस कंपाउंड, सो दिस इज द डी टाइप ऑफ प्रोटॉन, and this is d type of proton, and around this type of, this d type of proton there are two protons, there are two protons in the neighborhood position, if there are two proton then the signal of this d type of proton is splitted into the triplet, so this is the a option is the correct option. How many signals will appear in NMR spectra of butyl methyl ether? So butyl methyl ether is compound is actually the there are butyl group and methyl group in the compound, so there are actually the five type of the protons, so five signal will appear for butyl methyl ether, right, so that's it, hope you learned the information or knowledge or the concept about the interpretation of NMR signal for various type of the compounds. Okay, thank you, if you have any type of the doubt then you can ask me. Okay, thank you.